news was run from Richmond in that fading April sun. That Lee had handed Grant his sword, the war was finally won. Into the streets the people spilled, feeling the excitement build. And the crowd around the White House milled, asking, is it true? It's finally done. Inside the White House, Lincoln heard them calling out his name. He sat there wondering what to say to ease their years of pain. Someone yelled, come out the door and tell us what you got in store for the rebels who have lost the war. So out upon the porch, Abe Lincoln came. He said, we are gathered not in anger, but in celebration. Let's be grateful we are once again a single nation. Let's stand together, reassured, now that peace has been secured. Our nation's illness can be cured, and I suggest the overture for this occasion. He said, let the band play Dixie, play that tune that holds its head up high and proud, and let our nation, once divided, bloody but unbowed, take the swords of war and beat them back into a plow. On the day that Lee surrendered, Mr. Lincoln told the crowd, let the band play Dixie. A tired Union soldier hobbled on his only limb, filled with bitter memories the war had left with him. Dragged his wooden leg and cane, his face was set and creased with pain. He stumbled, fell, and rose again, and he wondered what the future held for him. He spied a black child kneeling there in humble gratitude. He knelt down right beside her to share her thankful mood. Grateful words were raised in prayer. God, in your sweet loving care, our broken lives now please repair. Let our wounded nation be renewed. And let the band play Dixie, play that tune that holds its head up high and proud. And let our nation, once divided, bloody but unbowed, take the swords of war and beat them back into a plow. On the day that Lee surrendered, Mr. Lincoln told the crowd, let the band play Dixie. Let the band play Dixie.